So how about making drones even more intelligent by bringing the AI intelligence developed and trained in the cloud onto the drones themselves? That's exactly what Neil did, combining Azure Percept and a drone. That's today on the IoT Show. Hi, everyone. This is the IoT Show. I'm Olivier, your host, and today we'll talk drones. Who doesn't like a good drone? And for that, we have Neil invited to the show today. Neil, how are you?
Doing well. Thank you for having me. I'm really thrilled to talk about drone technology and the intelligent edge today.
Yeah, so I hear and we can see behind you, you put together an Azure Percept DK with a drone. So before we get to the point, and people, I'm sure, are already excited about learning more about this, more than just a little experiment. Tell us about yourself and how you came to mixing and matching these technologies.
Sure, sure. So I'm a Microsoft Principal Cloud Solution Architect on the AI Ranger team. I'm also a certified commercial drone pilot. And to those drone pilots out there, known as an FAA Part 107 certification for small unmanned aircraft systems, but we'll just call it drone today.
Yeah. Well, for most of the audience, I'm guessing this is going to be what is going to trigger their interest anyways. First, before I need to ask, you know, how did you get to, which one is your job, right? Are you like a technical specialist for Microsoft or drone pilots and or both, or is it just for fun? What's going on here?
So I am my day job, cloud solution architect, working on intelligent edge solutions, and I've done a lot of side work, and incredibly enthusiastic and passionate about drone technology, autonomous drones, custom-made drones, how to move drones into different spaces commercially as well as for a hobby. So I took my day job and my passion, put them together, and we have an opportunity to talk about some intelligent edge solutions with the Azure Percept development kit.
Yeah, and we very often, you know, have the imagination going on, right? So what could be done with drones? And we have vision videos of things that could be done. I remember actually a build keynote with Sam George like 3 years ago, where we had a drone flying over a set of pipes and detecting an anomaly down there. And interestingly, at that time, it was kind of not faked, but almost, you know, the drone was just there to capture the image. And then the analytics was happening somewhere else. But here, you combine the Azure Percept device, which has capabilities to do AI, basically on board with the camera, microphones, and so on, with a drone to send out that intelligent device up on top of what your roof or someone's roof to do some inspection. So tell us a bit about this project, and then we'll walk through the video when you give us a go, and we'll talk about this this montage of yours here.
Excellent. So I was inspired by that inspection use case that we saw on stage. And what I've done here is created a roof inspection use case. This one happens to be for residential roofs, but it can apply to commercial roofs, can commercial apply to other properties. But what I did is I really looked forward to creating a use case to not only inspect residential roofs, which is accessible to a very large audience, but applicable to another audience that might want to take up a solution like this for commercial roofs. Okay. Now, a lot of fun doing it.
I bet, you know, combining your work with a passion is very often, and that's one of the things that working in IoT we get to do, and very often. So let's roll that video, and while we're watching it, tell us what we're looking at right now.
Sure. So in this video, what we're looking at is several different components. We're looking at a map to the right, which contains a series of waypoints noted by the green pins. And we're looking at some instrumentation on the left, which is coming from the drone itself. Now, there's two components. There's the drone and the intelligent edge, the Percept on the drone itself. So this route that I've created over this property is programmed and uploaded to the drone flight computer itself. So when I take off and set a route and tell it to go, it autonomously flies over the roof without any need for control via a controller in my hand or another pilot doing this. So it really enables the drone to go across the roof without any real input. So we can concentrate on the results that are coming from the Percept. Now, as we move this forward, we'll see a little icon. It's a drone, and we've reached the roof where we're actually looking through a web stream coming from the Percept, and we're noting areas on this roof. So I have programmed a custom vision model to look for scrapes, lifting of shingles, and discoloration.
Okay. You basically like send out to your drone over the roof, capture images, and train the model to detect the anomalies, it would say, or the problems, potential problems on the roof, right?
Right. Okay. Exactly.
That. Okay. So here we're looking at the web stream, right? Which is one of the features of Azure Percept, allowing you to eventually have a live view of what the Azure Percept DK is seeing and how it's analyzing the image to detect these problems, these errors based on the model. You would not send that web stream, you know, up to the web from the drone, right?
No. So what we're looking at is web stream coming from the drone itself. So we are on the edge. We are using inference coming from the drone, real time via the camera that's actually picking up images or video or recording of the roof condition itself. So we're not recording or grabbing video and sending it up to Azure for inference. It's all happening on the edge. It's all happening in the Percept or on the Percept on the drone in real time. So we're able to look at that web stream and see what's happening in real time.
And that's pretty interesting because someone would assume that analyzing images, detecting anomalies on an image is something that's kind of heavy in terms of compute. So they would need some beefy graphics card on a big machine server, whatnot, or use the cloud for that. But here, you're embedding that model thanks to Azure Percept and the technologies underneath Azure IoT Edge and so forth in order to run that on the drone itself. But tell me about you know, why. Why would someone want to run AI directly on the drone? What are the use cases we can see for that?
So typically in an inspection use case, you might have a drone that goes up and captures video. And then that video is downloaded from the drone. It might sit in an office in a backlog, might have to have an engineer interpret the results of that video, and then a delay in results or a delay in a report. So what we're looking at now is, again, real-time inspection, real-time identification of damage and defects, and that can be shown based on this video recording and provided to a client much faster than waiting for a recording to be inspected, waiting for a recording to be viewed or interpreted, and then a report compiled and then sent to the customer. I think we cut down the workflow significantly. Also, we have the opportunity to show additional detail that maybe the inspector or the individual piloting the drone and then watching the video later just didn't catch, just based on how the model was trained.
Yeah, totally. And I can imagine also the operator, the inspector, was receiving the messages about, hey, there's a problem here, and eventually wants to do a second pass or wants to, you know, take control of the drone to go look closer exactly at that spot that has been detected as faulty and do that because they have the data immediately, after that drone went through its route and was able to give you that information locally, right?
Exactly. So there's a couple other pieces of information that can help with this report and really inform and help the operator understand what they're looking at. Since the Percept connects to the IoT hub, we're receiving telemetry from the model of identification of damage or defects via bounding boxes in this example. So we can correlate damage and defects to location. We can potentially GPS tag those, and we can have better evidence of where those damage and defect items are found on the roof. Now, I think that, again, increases workflow, speed of workflow to going from initial looking at the roof to providing a report. In addition, we can improve the model We can iterate on training the model and provide additional information about a different kind of defect. Let's say an inspector wanted to look for shingles that were completely removed or gone. You can iterate on that model. You can retrain the model and improve it to also identify missing shingles. So you can today look for a problem set of items. And then tomorrow, after retraining this model, which happens very rapidly via Azure Custom Vision, you can enhance what you're looking for or enhance the results that you're looking for. An example could be you're doing residential roofs in a neighborhood. Tomorrow, you might be in a disaster zone, or you might be in an area where you're inspecting for damage based on a hailstorm.
Yeah, and now you're talking to the drone pilots, the professional ones, the ones who are making money out of that because they're doing these different jobs. How hard is it for someone who's a drone pilot typically and not like you, savvy in cloud technology or embedded technologies? How hard would that be for them to push a new model and update the software on that device, on the drone itself?
Very easy. So I went from zero to prototype within a couple days. And what I used is Azure Custom Vision, which is a no-code solution. Mm-hmm. What I did is I took photos, uploaded those photos to Azure Custom Vision. I tagged the areas, the scrapes, the lifting of shingles, the discoloration. I tagged those all within the web interface. I saved that model and I trained it. And after that, the Percept Studio in Azure itself handled all of the deployment. So didn't have to download a model onto an SD card, didn't have to connect via USB cable, didn't have to do some of the other types of activities it takes to update companion computers or other types of technology that are now used in drones. Yeah. So it's very, very simple.
Cool, Neil. So seems indeed pretty simple to push your models to the drone, in that case, to the Azure Percept device. So that opens up for tons of new scenarios. Here we saw a real-life scenario, which is inspection of a rooftop. But there are other ones that your customers that you're talking to daily are interested in. Can you mention some of them?
Sure. So we're working with a couple of customers in the agriculture space. So we're looking at inspecting crops for damage, especially after storms. We're also looking, also in the agriculture space, looking for areas where irrigation may not be 100% correct. You might have puddles of water. You might have other areas that are not getting enough water. So using an elevated platform like a drone to go and look at the entire crop, as opposed to using an insurance adjuster to walk the crops or drive through various areas, has saved a lot of time in that area. Also, we're talking to one other company that runs theme parks across the country and actually across the world. And one of the things we're talking about is ride maintenance or predictive maintenance. Now, the current use case is an individual climbs a very high spaces, roller coasters, things like that, other rides, and inspects them at pretty long intervals, 30 days, maybe more. Now, we've explored the idea of sending a drone up, using the Percept to inspect the tracks, or even using a route like what we saw for residential inspection or residential roof inspection, where we can autonomously have the drone traverse the tracks and look for hotspots, damage, rust, various other things. So we're really exploring a lot of different spaces right now. A couple other areas we're thinking about, pipeline inspection. We saw that example on stage a couple of years ago. We also are looking at cell tower inspection. So the reason why a lot of these use cases have come about is because there's a safety aspect. Even either an individual needs to climb a ladder to a very high place. There's fall hazards. There's other hazards with EMF or other kinds of electrical emissions. Radio towers might be damaging to human beings for just microwave and other areas. Whereas a drone, it might make more sense to send a craft up like that and take a look around as opposed to having individuals go up very, very high.
Yeah, and you were saying the scenario of the theme park inspecting the rides is something that an individual will go once every third day, right? Because right. it's physically hard. There's like lots of places to go. You have to set up, just stop mm-hmm. everything or do it at night. And then it takes time to get up there, right? So the drone is going to be like, poof, up there. And then and you can inspect more often as well, right? You can have an inspection daily versus mm-hmm. once every 30 day. And the other aspect of the scenarios you were describing that triggered some reaction were, you know, when you're in a remote place, you don't have internet connectivity. There's no network connectivity. And this is where we bring it back to the reason of having the intelligence running directly on the device itself, that you can go in remote places and have the inspection happen. Whether it's, as we're saying, you know, could be power lines, could be, mm-hmm. you know, rods in a gas extraction area or site, this kind of things, you know, could will require recording the images and then do all the analytics, you know, afterwards with delays and so on. Well, here the inspector goes, runs the drone, goes through the whole inspection, and then tells, hey, you have to fix that now. Don't go back and come back next week. Do it now, or so forth. So that's the kind of scenarios that or reaction that your examples triggered for me.
Yeah, great example. Just to expand a little bit on the ride example. Mm-hmm. So there have to safety lockouts. You have to make sure the ride is not running. Mm-hmm. One of the reasons why it's every 30 days, because that's the window for those safety lockouts, and it's also not prime time. So if you fly a drone under an autonomous path collecting all of that data, number one, it can go faster than an individual walking the tracks. Number two, not as many, I shouldn't say not as many safety lockouts, but mm-hmm. not the need for such an elongated session to lock the ride out. Since mm-hmm. the drone is faster, it might take 45 minutes as opposed to an entire day to take the ride down.
Yeah, that makes plenty of sense. And I think there's plenty of other scenarios we can definitely apply this kind of requirements or advantages in that case. Mm-hmm. So that's great, Neil. Combining Azure Percept Edge Intelligence with a drone. We've seen it, but here it's becoming real. I appreciate your time and coming to the show today. You did put together a blog post that goes into details into your project. So we'll bring up a URL down there, akshow.com/AzurePerceptDrone. Neil, thanks for your time once again. You're welcome back to the IoT show. As you know, everyone appreciates this kind of project.
Absolutely. We are working on many new things, and I really enjoyed my time and hope to bring some new innovations forward, and hope to see you soon.
You will, for sure. Like new innovation with IoT and edge intelligence and drones, I'm in, no problem. Everyone, thanks for tuning in and watching the IoT show. See you soon. Bye.